So you're thinking about moving, relocating, or heavens forbid, you're gonna leave the gorgeous, beautiful, perfect state of California? Well, in this video today, we're talking about my top 10 things that you have to do to get your house ready and sell for top dollar. So stay tuned. What's up, everyone? It's Rachel Capill here with Keller Williams, East Bay. If you want to know all things San Francisco Bay Area related and what it's like living and playing in the Bay, this is a channel for you. Click that subscribe button down below. We got you covered when moving or relocating within the Bay too. So smash that like bell if you got some value. And big shout out to those people that have been asking our team questions about the Bay. We love it, so keep them coming. Make sure to email, DM, PM, whatever you feel comfortable with. And we are here for you in relocating to the Bay Area. All right, so let's get into this video, my top 10 tips that you've got to do if you want to sell that house for top dollar in this market. So number one, you need a realtor that actually is in the market on a daily basis and that cares about you and what's right for your family. Numero two, you've got to declutter your stuff. Get rid of that crap, get it out, minimize, and recondo your life. I like to say declutter and de-stress my environment. So big deal is to get rid of like 50 to 75% of your stuff. I mean, if you're gonna be moving, you gotta pack it up anyway. So get a pod, get it out, toss it. If you haven't worn it in 5 years, deuces, it's done. You don't need it, you don't need it. It's just providing more stress, more stuff, more stress. So declutter your house and space, make it look minimalist is better because people like to envision their space. So the less junk you have, the less stress you're gonna have, number one, but the less anxiety and fear that people are gonna have in walking in your house. So number two is you gotta declutter and you gotta get that space right and clean and just think minimalist. Rid of all that stuff in the closets, make it look like the home edits, put stuff in a garage, but like try to keep it organized, right? So people don't get overwhelmed and get turned off by that. Cause it's amazing the psychology of people and how they think when they see a lot of stuff and clutter. When you look at your feed and Instagram and you see Marie Kondo and the home edit, you realize, oh my God, I wish I could have a life like that. It's not completely attainable all the time, but if you can get those closets kind of spaced out where it looks a little bit cleaner and not just crammed in there, you wanna think minimalist and just pack it up and put it in a pod. I'm telling you, this is going to save your life. It's gonna make you feel better and you're gonna be in the zen zone and unstressed and feel great. All right, number three is you wanna fix as much as you can. So if you've got that honey-do list, put your man or woman to work. Make them fix stuff. You wanna keep everything, you know, kind of current. So what does that mean? Fresh paint, you know, if you could do things like removing old floors, like carpet, like get rid of it, put new carpet in. Like you wanna clean up and fix as much as you can. Obviously, like we can't all afford to do that. But in my listings, what I like to do is fresh paint, clean up the landscape, make everything look really nice, have that curb appeal inside and outside. You'd be amazed at what just fresh coat of paint is and having cleaners come and replacing old knobs, like maybe changing out the handles to knobs. I mean, we can do a kitchen for a really good price, just a surface kind of clean, paint the cabinets, make it, bring it up to date. You know, if you have a decent sized budget, it's amazing what that return can be on the sale of your house. So you wanna fix things that are broken, light switches, whatever, you know, it could be broken ceiling fans, replace them if you can. If it's like $100, I have vendors that can do all of this. So with my listings, I like to get everything in tip top shape. I like to do a fresh coat of paint. I like to clean up all the things that need to be fixed and the garden and the front and back, just so, you know, potential clients can come in and see exactly like, oh my gosh, this is beautiful. Because if you don't fix these things and you don't paint and clean up, what they're gonna do is they're gonna walk through the house and say, oof, that needs new paint. That like beige is really bad. And that's not gonna match my teal couch, you know, or my royal blue couch. So that won't work. And then we're gonna have to paint that. So then they start taking, you know, dollar signs off of it. So if you can bring a beautiful clean canvas to the next potential owner, you're gonna get top dollar for your home. So number three is fix everything that you can afford, bring the property up to date, and get that curb appeal going. Number 4 is you want to depersonalize the home. So even though we as a family love seeing little Johnny and Bobby and Javier and Cindy, we don't necessarily want to see them in the house, because what happens is clients will walk through the house and be like, oh my gosh, look at this beautiful couple. What? I wonder if I know them. Oh my gosh, is that Johnny? Oh, that's weird. That'd be weird. I'm buying Cindy and Johnny's house. Gosh, I know them from daycare. So you just don't want to have any kind of thoughts like that going through people's head. Just like you don't want them to walk through and take dollar signs off of your home sale because the paint is beige. So we want to depersonalize the home. We want to keep it a fresh, clean state so people can walk through and they can say, oh my gosh, my beautiful blue couch or neon green sign will work perfectly on that white wall or gray wall that's a super neutral color. Okay, so you want to depersonalize the home before you put it on the market. No pictures of your grandma that was alive in the 1920s and lived through World War II, even though I have pictures of my grandfather. And I love them, but when I'm going to sell my home, I'm not going to keep them up. I'm going to pack them away and I'm going to put them in that pot because I want to sell my home for top dollar, and that's what I know is going to help it sell. So number 4, depersonalize the home so people can envision themselves living in your beautiful, perfect, gorgeous home. So number 5 is we stage the home, period, no matter what, end of story. Data shows that staging a home can provide a 6 to 10% higher return and sell 25% faster. So why we stage a home? And if you're living in the home, you know, totally understandable. We get a stager in there. My stager is amazing. I love her. She sells always for top dollar and super fast. I love her. She's just got this impeccable sense of style. So what she does is she'll come in and see, okay, well, we've got this couch we can work with. Let's get rid of this. Let's get rid of that. And she'll stage with your furniture. So is it inconvenient? 100%. But moving's inconvenient, right? We want to hit the goal, which is sell the house for top dollar. So when you get somebody in there to stage, what they do is they can take your furniture and work with it, their furniture, and make it beautiful. So home buyers will walk in and they'll be like, oh my gosh, like, this is gorgeous. And they won't think of like the rocking chair that was like 50 years old that you love, that is super comfortable, but like just isn't up to speed, right, with today's standards. So we love the rocking chair, but put it in the storage. So they can envision exactly what's going on, because what happens all the time, and I have shown enough buyers this, and it's so funny. I wish I could just like show you reactions of people, but they walk into an unstaged home and they literally for like 5 or 10 minutes, they'll stop and they'll think and they'll be like, well, no, I could put the couch there. Wait, but no, that wouldn't work because the curve of the wall. Well, it takes them like 10 to 15 minutes to like figure out how they can actually see themselves living in the space. So when you literally have all that figured out for them, it's done. They don't have to think. They can say, oh, my couch is perfect. It's a sectional. It's not a single couch, but you know, we could make it work because that chair right there would act as a sectional. Like it's like an instant, I see, this could work. Whereas they walk in, no staging, it's like, I can't see it. I'm telling you, promise. I promise you that if you stage it, it is 100% better than if you don't stage it, because I see it all the time with buyers. They can't envision it. And we, as human beings, we need to be able to see it. Some people are more creative than others. 99% of people cannot see it. So we need to help them see exactly how perfect it is. So staging is a non-negotiable. Number 6 is have to, non-negotiable again, get professional photography to market your listing. If your agent doesn't want to do this, bye, because professional photos are essential. We can't talk about it. It's just, you have to do it, okay? You just have to. And some of you that know me know that I had a professional photography business for 15 years, very successful. And I'm not just saying that because of that. I'm saying it because professional photos work. So all of you agents out there that are cheaping out on professional photos, shame on you. Okay, number 7 is get inspections done. I always suggest to get home inspections because it just gives a clear picture of the property, and it helps you when things you know, when we come time for the offers, it helps because when you have a home inspection and it looks like an A+ inspection, minus a couple things like a crack in a window or a hairline crack here, it helps when you have little cosmetic fixes that are really not a big deal. You can just say, we're not negotiating that. It's cosmetic. That's your problem. It's not a big deal. Or if you need a new roof, right? Your roof might have like 2 years left, a year left. And that is something that you need to decide with your agent what you want to do with. But I tell my clients all the time, it's always a good idea to get sewer lateral, termite, home inspection, roof inspection. If you can afford all of those, great. If you can't, let's do the minimum of termite and home inspection, because it just creates a better picture of the home and it puts the right foot forward. And I love Keller Williams for teaching me to do this in the very beginning of my career. And I think it's a very useful tool to help with negotiations. Number 8 is price your home right. Now, we are not gonna get into this loaded question because everything changes, and I'm gonna defer back to numero uno, which is hiring the right realtor, because you need to have a realtor in the market every single day, every week. This is their deal. This is not like a weekend warrior where they know exactly what's going on in your neighborhood. They know what houses are gonna be on the market. Really good to just know what's going on and how many people are offering, how many people are going through that house. And this kind of data will help you basically price your home right, because we all know, I mean, except for you guys that are watching this video, I guess real estate agents and people in the market know that the reason why a house doesn't sell, the numero uno reason why, is because it's not priced right. So if you price the home right, comparative to everything else in the neighborhood, you're gonna sell it. And oftentimes you will sell it for a top dollar, all depending on the market and what's going on. Number 9 is you have to use social media to be marketing your property. If you are working with an agent that does not use social media to market your property, hey, more power to you. But I'm telling you, in this day and age and with COVID, it's huge. Nobody's gonna argue that. It's huge. Now, 100%, houses are selling, flying. But like, if we're not using social media, people, we are missing out. So, number 9, your agent, you, everyone must be using social media, okay? It's a non-negotiable, like staging and photos and choosing. Number 10 is my little secret sauce. And you may think I'm a little woo-woo, but I don't care because I ain't afraid of judgment. My secret sauce, number 10, is I want always my clients, me, everybody involved in this transaction to be visualizing success. We don't need to be seeing anything kind of scary. What if, what if, what if? We need to be positive and we need to visualize success, because it will happen, I promise you. Stay positive, visualize your success, and you're gonna have it, I promise. Telling you, call it woo-woo, call it whatever you want. But I do it every time and it works. So that's my number 10. Visualize your success. All right, so there you have it, my top 10 tips and tricks to getting your house sold for top dollar. If you have questions, give us a shout. We're here for you. Our team loves it. So just call, text, DM, email, PM, whatever you feel comfortable with. We got you covered when relocating or moving out of this perfect, beautiful, golden state of California. I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video. Bye.